We all know about the importance of workflow and efficiency in music production, yet the practicality of such concepts can be ambiguous. So, here's how Grammy Award winner Luca Pretolesi approaches it. I'll be demonstrating this process in Ableton, but the concepts apply equally to other doors. The first step is to hide anything you don't use, creating more space for what you do. Nearly every door has a quick search feature, letting you hit a keyboard shortcut and instantly start typing to find a plugin. In Live, this shortcut searches everything indexed in the browser, including projects, samples, and presets, often cluttering up the results. This is where saved searches come in. Most users rely on Live's 7 collection tags for organization, but since Live 12, saved searches offer a much more efficient workflow. This is Luca's setup, which is in the description for easy copy and pasting. Live doesn't support smart filters, so a true recent option isn't possible, though you can use the browser arrows to navigate through previous searches and locations. Everything else is easily accomplished and will look like this when completed. I'll walk you through setting up the first collection, EQs, which you'll then need to repeat for each plugin category. I don't care for separating EQs into analog and digital, so we'll place everything within a single search. Let's get started. Navigate to All under Library, then toggle down the Filters panel. A key decision here is choosing which plugin format to use, and it's not as straightforward as you might think. For example, I'm on Mac, but avoid audio units so I can share projects with Windows users and ensure compatibility if I ever switch systems. So I'll select VST3, which will filter the browser to show only plugins in this format. Next, go to the top right and hit Edit. Click Add Group. I'll use my own name, you might prefer using your artist name. This creates a group to nest all of our tags under. Now, hit Add Tag and paste in the first search term. Then, scroll through your plugin list, select the EQ you want to tag, and tick the box. When all of your EQs are tagged, click the Edit button again to exit edit mode. Now, under your group name, you'll have that category saved. To add this to your browser, select it, hit the plus symbol, remove the extra text Live adds, and hit enter. Repeat this process for each search category. It takes some time, but only needs to be done once. For the favorites category, I prefer using the collections tab since it's much faster and I frequently update it based on my most used plugins. You can organize the rest however you like, but for reference, my setup looks like this. Favorite plugins, Live Racks, Max for Live Devices, drum samples and kits I'm using, frequently used samples, past projects, which is particularly useful in Ableton since you can open a .als folder and import specific channels, including clips, plugins, and MIDI data, great for recycling old ideas, and reference tracks for mixing. To create these, you'll need to add all the system folders to your Live browser. You can do this by dragging and dropping the folder from your system browser directly into Live's browser. I also keep some additional folders down here as I have the screen space. These folders contain everything I own, while the collections are a selection of the best of or most used options. The goal with this setup is to ensure that when I'm in Ableton working in full screen, I never have to leave the window to create music. I share many more techniques like this in my free weekly newsletter. Consider signing up via the link below. Check out this video to learn how Luca Pretolesi gain stages his mixes. Thank you for watching.